E-paper display is perfect choice for autonomous project which focus on a low power consumption. This 2.9-inch display is more power efficient than small LED. Moreover, it still shows the rendered picture even when disconnect the power source. In this video, I want to show you step-by-step process of creating tiny panel which displays the views and subscriptions count for my YouTube channel. If my calculations correct, tiny battery could power the project for more than 60 days without charging. I'm using 3-color display module from V-Act, which I found for $8 on AliExpress. According to specification, it can be powered by 3.3 volt, exactly as ESP32, and over refresh phase consumes around 26 milliwatts. The downside of the device is rendering time. It takes 3 seconds for black and white variant. Black, white, red takes around 19 seconds. However, it's okay for my purposes, since I'm planning to update it only 3 times per day. The display uses SPI for communication and fortunately ESP supports it too without any additional hardware. To build this project, I'm going to use ESP32 Wroom without devboard to be able to fit electronics in a small case. 200 mAh LiPo battery will power the project. And since it has nominal 3.7 voltage, I need a converter to get a 3.3 volt. Lastly, to charge the battery, I'm going to use Type-C charging module. Connection of the display to ESP is pretty simple. Data line, SDA, should be connected to MOSI pin of ESP. Clock, SLT, to clock. Other data pins could be assigned to any GPIO which you want. To avoid implementation SPI communication from scratch, I'm going to use GX-EPD2 library which is designed for e-paper displays. It built upon Adafruit GFX library, so drawing images and writing text requires almost no effort. For now, to test the display works and wired correctly, let's create simple Hello World sketch. At first, I install necessary library. As being said, we need to connect but can omit defining for clock and data line. I'm using 2.9-inch display, 296 pixel wide, so my instance looks like this. In the video description, you can find the link to repository with the other examples and display instances. In setup function, I need the display and change orientation to landscape. Then I write the test text. After uploading sketch and starting up ESP, screen start flashing. It's a normal behavior which caused by screen's nature. Drawing images is a bit trickier. Technically, we need to specify the whole image pixel by pixel using bitmaps. Here how it works. First, we need to define drawing area. In my case, 8x8. Then convert image into 2-color pixel map. Then every 8 pixels should be converted to binary representation where 1 is filled pixel and 0 is empty space. Lastly, to keep records shorter, binary numbers converted into hexadecimal values. As output, we get a bitmap that should be fed into appropriate method. To convert YouTube logo for my project into bitmap, I tried to find a good online tool, but unsuccessfully. The only working tool I found is Image2LCD application, which works awful on Mac under Wine. Fortunately, it did its job. Before we continue, I want to show you a high-level diagram of this device workflow. Once ESP started, it should connect to Wi-Fi. For very first connection, I'm going to use Wi-Fi manager from previous video. The link should appear in top right corner. When connection established, ESP requests data from YouTube and turn off the Wi-Fi. The data displayed on the screen. As a final stage, ESP goes into hibernate mode for 8 hours and repeats the process again. In such approach, I approximately use Wi-Fi for 10 seconds per cycle, 20 seconds idle for ESP, and 20 seconds for drawing the image. If my number is correct, the energy consumption for 30 seconds is 0.7 mAh hour. With my battery, device should work at least 2 months without charging. To retrieve the data from YouTube, I'm going to use YouTube Data API. And I was always Google API's hater, and this case is not an exceptional. To create API key, you need to navigate Google console and then create project if you don't have it. Then find the API and services page, and you need to enable YouTube Data API v3. After that, navigate credentials section and create API key. Finally, restrict the key by adding services it can access to. In our case, it's YouTube. Now, by providing the API key and channel ID, you can access the statistic. Arduino Framework has inbuilt HTTP client, so you can perform the request without additional libraries. However, Arduino JSON will simplify your life a lot. The whole code of the project you can find on GitHub by link in the description. After finishing the coding part and flashing the ESP, I designed a simple box to hold all electronics. Since GLC PCB didn't reach me, I'm going to solder everything in old-school way without manufactured PCB. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions or faced with any issues with this project. And thanks for watching!